Hi and welcome, it's Vicky here and today I'm showcasing the December card kit by Simon Says Stamp. If you want to win this card kit, make sure to visit my blog, you will find the link down below and you have to leave me a comment there. So first let's take a look on what's included and then I'm going to share some inspiration. First of all, you get three envelopes. They have adhesive at the top so you don't have to leak and you will get a metallic red, a metallic khaki as well as a white one. Now let's take a look at the paper pad. If you are a fan of traditional color combinations when it comes to Christmas, then you are going to absolutely love them. Now these have lovely designs like this one, for example, that you can cut out and stick it on a slimline card. There are lovely pattern papers. As you can see, there are 12 double-sided pages here. And this is actually the collection by Simple Stories, which is called Vintage North Pole. And these are all 6x8 papers. Plus, there are these two pages which give you 8 rectangles that you can cut out and use them as your focal point on front of the card. Quick and simple to use. You will also get a mini bottle of glossy accent, perfect if you want to add some shine on your cards. And you also will get the new color by Tim Holtz. This is Rustic Wilderness, a lovely shade of green, perfect for Christmas. And it's not available in a mini yet. I think it's going to be available after February or something, but you do get it exclusively in the kit. You also get this huge stamp set full of sentiments. There is a lovely border that you can stamp and color as well as a mistletoe. It's a 6x8 stamp set and it's called Joyful Season. You can get it separately if you want to. This is a set of dies that you get in the kit. It's the Candy Cane Heart die set. It does die cut the candy cane as well as a couple of strings if you want to hang it from the top of your card. This is absolutely adorable and I will be using it on my card today. You do get ephemera, but I'm going to open up the package later on. First, let's take a look at those trimmings. These are velvet ribbons and they come from the Tim Holtz Ideology collection. They are the Christmas velvet trims and they are absolutely adorable. Such a lovely texture. Well, you do get some candy, just like always. And finally, you will get these 4 cardstock colors, one red, one dark green and a couple of white ones. Now let me clean up my area and then I'm going to open up the ephemera so you can see all the designs that you get. So again, all the ephemera follow the Christmas traditional color combo and you will find frames, banners, sentiments and lots of images perfect for using them as focal points. So let's start with the card for today. I am going to work first on the background and for that I picked one of the pattern papers that has this lovely collage on top. And I think since I'm going for a vintage style and look, it is the perfect opportunity to use my new paper trimmer. So this is the Deckled Edge paper trimmer by Tim Holtz. I'm going to cut out a piece that is slightly smaller than the standard card, so about a quarter of an inch smaller from each side. And you have the option to decide which parts of the pattern paper you want to use. So probably you want to avoid the very busy parts. So I'm just checking out which parts I want so that I can cut out the rest. Now, for some strange reason, when I am using the paper trimmers by Tim Holtz, I always like to align my paper at the bottom. I find it easier for me since it is closer and I can see the numbers better. Now, I am aligning it directly at the bottom and although these edges are trimmed, I did find that it does cut out nicely, so they are not wonky at all. I absolutely love the cutout edges and I'm going to enhance that vintage look by using some distress ink and this is not oxide. I went back to my original distress inks lately. I find that they are vibrant and I missed using them. So this time I'm working with vintage photo and I'm going to ink up the edges. Now I'm die cutting the candy cane heart. There are 2 parts, one out of white cardstock, the other out of red cardstock, and then I can stick one on top of the other. To stick everything together, I'm using my trusted Nouveau Deluxe glue. This is my favorite just because it has a really fine tip. It grabs papers really quickly so you don't have to wait a lot of time. Plus, when it oozes in between those areas, like for example in the candy cane, it's not going to show when it dries, so it dries completely matte and hides the mess. You can use the hard candy cane as it is. I decided to align them on top of my card differently. That's why I'm separating the two. And to get the same look and feel with the background, I do ink up the edges, not all over the place. I don't want to use that white paper on top. However, I don't want it to be super bright. From the ephemera pack, I did pick up this frame, and I'm trying to find something to bug it up to add as a background. So I tried some pattern papers. I did try some craft cardstock, but I decided to use the cardstock that was included in the kit, and it is a really dark green. Again, I'm going to ink up the edges, always using my Distress Vintage Photo. I did add foam tape at the back of the frame, and I will stick this green panel on top. So I have a lovely frame that can go on top of my panel, and this is where I'm going to nest my focal point. I'm sticking those two candy canes together. I'm going to lay them on top of the frame so that I can see how long I want them to be, and just chop off a little bit from the bottom, and then I can stick them inside. I like how they nest at the bottom of the frame, but they go outside of the frame at the top. Now, at the middle where those two candy canes meet, you can create a little bow and stick it on top, which is what I'm going to do with one of the trimmings. A real bow could be really bulky with this velvet ribbon, so that's why I'm just going to tie a knot. Now I want to embellish the candy canes a little bit more by using some holly berry leaves, and for that I'm using one of the stamps from the stamp set, and I'm going to stamp them on this green pattern paper. I am going to change my mind later on, and I am going to explain why. However, I did let this process in the video, since I think it is important to see that sometimes I do make mistakes, but there is always a way to fix things up and change things a little bit until you make sure that you like the finished look. So I stamped the holly berries on the green pattern paper, and then I fuzzy cut it. I did ink up the edges with Vintage Photo, as I do with all the elements when I'm going for a vintage look. And then I'm going to stick everything together. For the holly leaves, I'm going with glue where those two candy canes meet, but you can see here that they don't stand out against the background, and that was the problem with me. I didn't have any light areas on the green holly berries, and that's why I didn't like it. Anyway, I'm using a glue dot here at the back of my ribbon, and I'm going to stick it on top. For the sentiment, I'm going to fuzzy cut this banner from the ephemera die cut that says Merry Christmas. Of course, I'm going to ink up the edges with Vintage Photo, just like I do with every other element for my card. And now finally it's time to stick everything down. For that I'm using glue for the back of the frame. It does have dimension after all already. But for the little banner, I'm going to use tiny little squares to pop it on the card. From the dark green cardstock, I'm going to cut out a panel that is the standard sized card, that's 4.25 by 5.5. And on top of that, I'm going to stick my other panel. So this way I have a lovely border, dark green, all around, that matches perfectly with the center of my frame. But this is where I decided that I don't like the holly berry leaves. That's why I'm fuzzy cutting them from this pattern paper. I was able to lift the glue dot from the ribbon and tuck underneath the fuzzy cut holly berries. So I think it looks better now. And here are some close-up photos. Don't forget, there is a giveaway for this card kit on my blog. Make sure to visit, you will find the link down below, along with a list of all the products that I used. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you'll all have a lovely weekend.